In this video, I'll be showing how to use this t-test template to solve this hypothesis test question. Since we're testing if the population mean is greater than 25, the alternative hypothesis will be mu greater than 25. And the null hypothesis in many texts will be mu equal 25, but we will use less than or equal to 25 to complement the alternative hypothesis. Now let's input the values. The sample size n is 15, and the sample mean is 27. We're given the variance of the sample as 16 here. So for the standard deviation, we can input equals square root of 16. The significance level alpha is 0.05, and the hypothesized mean is 25. Now this is a right-tailed or upper-tailed test, since the alternative hypothesis has a greater than sign. In the results here, we can see the critical value for the right-tailed test is 1.761. That is, we will reject the null hypothesis if the test statistic is greater than 1.761. The test statistic here is 1.936, which falls into the rejection region. The right-tailed p-value here is also less than our alpha of 0.05, indicating we should reject the null hypothesis. That is, we have sufficient evidence to conclude that the population mean is greater than 25 at alpha equals 0.05. Now, suppose we're testing if the population mean is different from 25. The alternative hypothesis would be that the mean is not equal to 25, and the null hypothesis would be that the mean equals 25. This is now a two-tailed test, with a two-tailed critical value of 2.145. Now our test statistic of 1.936 does not fall into the rejection region. The p-value is also greater than 0.05, indicating we should fail to reject the null hypothesis. We therefore cannot conclude that the population mean differs from 25 at alpha equals 0.05. Finally, suppose the sample mean is 22.5, and we're testing if the population mean is less than 25. The lower-tailed critical region will be t less than -1.761. Since a new test statistic falls into this critical region, or since our p-value is less than alpha equals 0.05, we reject the null hypothesis. Note, however, that we will fail to reject the null hypothesis at alpha equals 0.01. And that's how to use the template. Thanks for watching.